we're all coming because there's great Impressionist works here. We've got them in all the ads, that there's Degas, there's Manet, there's Monet, there's Pissarro, and there's Sisley, kind of the icons of Impressionism. But the show has a lot more to offer, and in fact, you're going to see how modern art came to be, the modern art we know today and we recognize, and that's where Mr. Henson's collection begins. So it begins, rather surprisingly, with two works, one by Dominique Ingres and another by Eugène Delacroix, who are by no means Impressionists, but their struggle, their artistic struggle, which is the struggle between the academic, Ingres, and Delacroix, the romantic, the struggle between the academy, drawing, the past and tradition, and Delacroix, who represented something modern, something free of the constrictions of the academy in the past, who delved into the realm of color, gives birth to the avant-garde of the 19th century. Before you meet the first Impressionist work, you're going to encounter landscape artists that are rebelling against the strictures of the past, because in the old system, the old hierarchical system of the academy, landscape was right at the bottom of the genres. And so they pick that as a place to liberate themselves from the past. And Corot, who is extremely important, particularly Monet, who extols him as the greatest artist and the most important landscape painter for the 19th century. The first room of Impressionists begins with four works by Monet and one by Manet, where you can see how important the lessons of the previous generations of artists have been. And then we go into another room where we have the luxury of seeing six astounding works by Pissarro, the great colorist. Then you progress into the next room where you have artists, because not all Impressionist painters are focused on landscape. Many of them use the figure as their prime subject. You can think of Renoir and Degas. And then we jump into post-Impressionism, because Mr. Henson did not see the end of the, kind of the avant-garde in the 19th century as ending entirely with Impressionism. And we have a pretty astounding room of paintings by Gauguin. And here we can see very much what I kind of hinted at the beginning, you know, with Delacroix and bringing the strength of color into the avant-garde movements of the 19th century. You can see its entire triumph with Gauguin, because their color takes over. We're no longer looking at artists looking at nature and trying to depict nature. We have an artist who revels in color for its expressive means and its decorative means, and color liberated from its descriptive function. And that's where Mr. Henson's collection ends, with Cezanne and Gauguin, those artists that kind of hint at the abstraction that's to come later in the 20th century. This is a wonderful opportunity for Canadian audiences to see a pretty spectacular collection that's normally hidden in a beautiful museum that sits on the outskirts of Copenhagen. While the collection is here, while it's on tour, it really is an opportunity, and you should come and visit.